teeth. And shorty got a man, but she saying wife me. I got chest coming in like a pair of Nikes. If I like it, then you know I'm finna get it. Just do it. Hit the bag and then I flip it, watch me do it. Just do it. All them all on my wrist, going stupid. Just do it. Tryna put them on, but they never do it. They're like, hold up, wait a minute, like don't make sense to really get it. I'm steady getting to the chicken, that tasty finger licking chicken. I mean, I'm getting to the good guap. Keep it racking my socks. Diamonds cost me a lot. Nike check up all of my socks. Hey. Hey, yo. Nike check.
Well, the onset of fall weather, certainly a welcome occurrence for folks in Silicon Valley. And we've got football on a gorgeous day here in Santa Clara as we are situated at Levi's Stadium. Nothing like the fanfare of introductions to an NFL game, and that was in evidence a moment ago. Fireworks, pyrotechnics, you name it. This crowd is ready as their guys get set to match up between the Los Angeles Rams and the San Francisco 49ers. And in hindsight, probably should have taken a knee as he only gets this out to the 16-yard line. So the ball down to the...
Yeah, I use a dub. I'ma win, I won't lose with this. Ay, yeah, I'ma act a fool with this. Ay, yeah, I'ma act a fool with this. Ay, yeah, I'ma act a fool with this. Ay, turn the knob, can't resist, I'm incredible. Yeah, came for the dollars, call it vegetable. Then I did the dash, can I catch me, bro? Ooh, then I did the dash, can I catch me, whoa? Your whole team is no competition. Boy, I did it by myself, it's a solo mission. Running up the charts, I'm a fool, dog. Turn the whole field to a schoolyard. Bunch of students ain't eating around here. I'm the GOAT, little man, and I made it loud and clear. Put the gas on them like I whipped the Cavalier. Show no love, got the confidence, no fear. I use a dub, I'ma win, I won't lose with this. Ay, yeah, I'ma act a fool with this. Ay, yeah, I'ma act a fool with this. Yeah, 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 I'ma act a fool with this. Okay, since like 9-5, I've been eager for this. Talent on the rise, I'm consistent with this. Trophy is the prize, ain't no gimmicks with this. Okay, now what's left on them? Told you I'ma flex on them. I did it all subtle, ooh, and then I hit that exit on them. Gotta blame my faith, cause these odds ain't got nothing on them. I secured it safe, for the cradle, I ain't dropping nothing. Only winning is exception, ain't no truce. Ain't no dub, ain't no L on my crew. Only winning is exception on my crew, yeah. I use a dub, I'ma win, I won't lose with this. Ay, yeah, I'ma act a fool with this. Ay, yeah, I'ma act a fool with this. Yeah, 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 I'ma act a fool with this. Okay, yeah, yeah, when I hit that.
in Silicon Valley, and we've got football on a gorgeous day here in Santa Clara as we are situated at Levi's Stadium. The scene a few moments ago, here it is. It's unlike any other in sport as both teams made their way out of the tunnel. These folks are fired up as their guys are ready to do battle between the Los Angeles Rams and the San Francisco 49ers. Now on first down, and down he goes on the pressure from the Rams defense. A bad start there, a big loss on their first play from scrimmage. It's second down. They'll run for the first time with DeAndre Swift. Got some room at the 30. And all the way up to the 45-yard line. A gain there of 30 big ones. They went with the nickel look defensively, so they had five defensive backs in there. Didn't help them stop the run.
Yeah, I love that, the nickel look. 5 cents, five DBs. But what also happens then, you take a big body off the field in order to insert that guy. So you're taking a big off for a little. And oftentimes you can run the football effectively against that defense.
And Murray in trouble here, and down he goes. Danielle Hunter able to record his fifth sack of the season.
I spent a lot of extra time preparing for this game watching this offensive line because they gave up 5 sacks last week in their loss. They just gave up another one now. They don't seem to be working together as a cohesive unit, right? 4 guys might have it right, but the 5th guy is giving something up. They've got to find a way to all get on the same page.
So after the sack, a scenario you certainly don't work on too often. Second and 24. Another try after the first down sack. Murray eluding the pressure right. And this is going to be intercepted. Picked up by Jesse Bates. And he will bring it back. It's an interception return for a Rams touchdown.
Graham Gano.
Make it back-to-back weeks now with a pick six for him. He had one a week ago.
Talk about being in the groove, and what are the odds of what we're seeing right here? You don't see it happen very often. Listen, if you get a pick six in a season, it's been a big year, let alone back-to-back weeks. Tell you this, I wouldn't play cards against this guy in the locker room.
Michael Dixon set to kick off.
So they throw the pick six. They'll get another shot at it now as this one's in the air. And that'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback.
At their own 25-yard line.
The 49er offense set to get this drive underway. After the pick six, they go right back to the air. And this will be incomplete. Physical play on the football there, and it's second down.
Brandon, we saw these defenders flying to the football in their win last week, and nothing has changed. They're still moving around quickly and forcing incompletions.
An incomplete pass leads to second and 10 from the 25. Sliding out of the pocket. That's caught by Kelly. And he's going to be dropped following a pickup of 7 past the 30 to the 32. They get 7 out of that, so they're left with a 3rd and 3. Able to get the first before he's taken down at the 36. They're able to convert with a gain of 4.
And how about that on 3rd down? So many different directions an offense can go. Throw it out wide to the receivers, get it to their speedy running back. They changed up everything and handed it to the fullback, and he surprised them all and picked up a 1st down.
They'll try a little trickery here on the end around. I don't think anyone in the building fooled right there, as that one is going to blow up in their faces. They'll wind up losing 11 on the play, and it'll make this a 2nd and long.
Push him back. Push him back.
And that'll be incomplete. Took a pretty good shot as he tried to pull that one in. Couldn't hang on third down.
Normally being a big-bodied receiver plays to their advantage downfield. Go up and make the catch, take the hit, and pick up yardage. But in this case, the hit was timed really well and popped it free from his grasp.
Out of the gun now on third down. And the Rams got him. They bring him down. Danielle Hunter in there to get him, and that is sack number six now for him on the year.
Well, that was their third sack of the ball game. Second in the league in sacks coming into this one. They're planning on making it a race to the top, aren't they?
Absolutely. They're looking up at that top spot, but they might be looking down at the second spot pretty soon. Officially just 27 yards there on the punt. And the Rams are going to start this drive in great field position as they take over. First down. Jones being chased out left. And he completes it to Westbrook. And he's out of bounds. Almost gets to the 10. That goes for a gain of 31. So how about this for field position after the big play? Inside the 15 now as they come up on first and 10. And he'll get into the end zone. Touchdown, Rams.
Anthony Miller.
Anthony Miller. His first touchdown on the year. And the Rams tack on to their advantage. And it's good. And they have jumped out here to a quick 14-0 first quarter lead. The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. And this will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback.
25-yard line.
The San Francisco offense ready to start their next drive. And the results for them have not been strong to this point. Two drives have ended in a turnover and then a punt.
So would it be too snarky for me to say that they've shown improvement? Because you had two drives with turnovers. Now they punted it away, so at least they didn't turn it over. So that's good, right?
You're going to get some angry users reaching out to you on social media.
Well, I don't mean to be. I was actually looking for the positive. Silver lining, you know.
Second and three. Nowhere to go here. He lost the football. And now the Rams have got it. Going the other way. And they are going to score on the fumble return. Touchdown, L.A.
Graham Gano on for the
extra. And Charles, look at the big fella. What a rumble that was. Not only to scoop it, but then take it the rest of the way for the touchdown.
And now you know they're going to have to hear about it from now on. The defensive backs, he's going to want to run with them, do their drills, the whole deal. He thinks he's the pace setter now.
It doesn't matter what happens in practice this week, he's smiling. And they will not get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback. The 49er offense set to get this drive underway.
And in just about every game we see, partner, what do we do when we look at the stat sheet? We go right to
the turnover differential. And he's going to have to eat this one as down he goes.
Nick Mullins.
I'm starting to feel for that quarterback back there. I mean, you know me. Normally, don't have a lot of empathy for the QB, right? In this case, definitely. He's been on constant duress this entire game. I don't know how he's surviving back there.
And to think, there's still a long way to go in this football game. They come up on second and long, and the pass protection just has not been there this afternoon. And this turns into disaster. He's not going to get forward progress. That'll be a safety. And the safety there, another mistake, and these mistakes just keep piling up.
How many more can they make? They put themselves in such a massive hole now, it's going to be difficult to dig out from under.
Yeah, for sure, they can't afford any more at this point.
Now, that's the kind of return you're looking for. To get into that spot on the field, that allows you to do a lot of things on offense.
Set to begin their next drive, the Rams offense at the line. And for them, a touchdown their last go around. Obviously, they'll be hoping to do that again.
And when you start plotting for this drive, when you start thinking to yourself, okay, what are we going to do? You don't go away from what you did before because that worked, but you have to be prepared for wrinkles and counters because you know they'll make some adjustments.
An incomplete pass on first down. That leads to a second and 10. Off the play fake. Jones. Looking right side, and that's complete to Watkins. And they'll work this down to the 40-yard line. Tackled there. That'll be a gain of 16. And it'll give them a fresh set of downs. The Rams with the football here to begin the second quarter as they've got it with a first and 10.
49ers nothing.
Off play action. Jones. This is caught inside the 15. And he's going to take this one in for a Rams touchdown. D.D. Westbrook, his fourth touchdown on the year as his guys continue to put this one out of reach. Gano now to add the extra point. And the lead is now an even 30.
The kick is good. Makes the score Rams 30. 49ers nothing.
The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away. Fielded a couple yards into the end zone. And a good return as he'll be stopped just shy of the 30-yard line.
At their own 29-yard line.
The San Francisco offense ready to start their next drive. And last time they surrendered the safety, we know they don't want to do that again.
That is just one of those oddities in scoring that we get. And it's just so strange to see that go up on the board. And then you got to make sure that that doesn't happen to your team again. They've got to take care of the ball.
But boy, it juices up the defense.
Oh, without a doubt. That's a great way to score some points.
To throw, and his throw is going to be incomplete. DeAndre Swift, the intended receiver that time, and that'll bring up second down.
It certainly didn't appear that that's where he wanted to go with the ball initially, so he tried to get something out of it by dumping it off to his running back unsuccessfully.
And boy, that one drops incomplete, but if he was hit a fraction sooner, it may have been a fumble.
A lot of times it's that first read that you have. Maybe you get it in pre-snap, and he locked in on his target, but he was covered quite well, and that one's incomplete.
Now they face a third and 10 after back-to-back incompletions. They'll stick with the passing game as he looks to throw. Man open, that's Ray McCloud. And he is going to have a 49ers first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. 15 for the Niners there and a first down.
First downs on this drive, but getting the incompletion there, that should give them something to build on and maybe turn the tide.
Into heavy traffic, and it's intercepted. Able to get there and pick it. was just one of those interceptions from our perspective here. We got a good view at the 50-yard line mid-level that quarterback and receiver were not on the same page.
Just by his reaction, I'm talking about the quarterback, he expected something different from his receiver, whether he expected him to break in, out, deeper, shorter. They'll determine that on the sideline. But bottom line, you could see that he thought he'd be in a different spot, except the defender was not his intended target.
From the midfield stripe, they'll look to throw. Got Gordon open, completes it. He'll be taken down at the 48 for a pickup of 2 yards. So second and 8 here after the pass play for 2 yards on first down. From the gun, Jones. Able to get this to Gordon. And that play will go nowhere. Losing yardage back near midfield at the 49.
Well, I know it goes against the instincts of the person catching the ball, because all you're ever taught is catch the football, don't drop it.
But drop it there.
Yeah, in that situation, dropping it would have been better. End up losing yardage, even though they completed the pass.
As good as a sack.
Yeah, how about that? Although they won't get the same credit for it, and it won't help them at contract time.
2 minutes gone by, second quarter. Jones on third down. Open man is Metcalf. He's got it. And he is going to have a Rams first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. A gain there of 12 yards and a first down LA. Now a throw here going to be taken in by the tight end Njoku. And they're going to be set up down around the 15-yard line. The catch and run good for 24 yards.
And what a nice example there of a tight end doing exactly what he needs to do. How about how he worked his way to the outside, made sure he secured the catch, and then anything after that, we count that as a bonus, and indeed, he gets enough for the first down.
Here's a throw to his running back. It's complete, and he's brought down just outside of the 10 at the 11. They'll contain him to just 4. Second down. He's got Njoku, his big tight end. And he's going to be brought down just shy of the 5 at the 6. That catch good for 5. It's third down. Operating from the gun, Jones. And this one goes incomplete. A first misfire there after 6 straight completions. And it leads to fourth down.
They really had a good drive going there, but a nice recovery by the defense these past few downs. Able to knock that one away on third down and bring up what I think for the offense, an unexpected fourth down here.
And no move to get the offense off the field. They'll stay put on fourth and 1. They'll run for it. It's Gordon. And he will have the first down before he's brought down at the 3. Just a gain of 3, but they'll certainly take it as they convert on fourth down. They'll try and punch it in. Gordon. And he's going to take this one in for a Rams touchdown. Melvin Gordon. His 4th touchdown on the year. And the Rams have got it on cruise control. And he's been a busy man. 5 for 5 now as he knocks another one through to extend the lead.
Rams 37, 49ers nothing.
Set now to kick this one away, and off it goes. Fielded a couple yards into the end zone. And he'll be stopped right around where he would have been had he gone down to a knee, maybe a yard shy of there at the 24.
24-yard line.
The 49er offense set to get this drive underway. And following the interception, just any interception, are you a little bit more cautious when you start that next drive, or no, you just throw that out the window?
I think you are. I don't think that there's any way you can run back out there and go, totally didn't affect me. Let's just go ahead and be loose with the football again. You're going to take care of it, but you have to be careful about being too cautious, because now you can't run any offense at all.
Still want to attack. We'll see how they attack him here. He'll try again with the arm here on second down. And down he goes on the pressure from the Rams defense. Danielle Hunter, he's the one to get him, and that is sack number 7 for him on the year.
Sack, sack. Got him. Blitz,
The Niners on third down. They've been okay, 2 for 3 thus far. This is 3rd and 16. They'll set up a throw. Oh, the pressure too great, and he goes down once more.
I think you saw the same thing that I did there, partner. Remember, he's their backup quarterback, so the last thing they need is to lose another one right here on the sack. Looks like he's going to be okay, though.
Yeah, he looked like he was favoring something in the left leg. Appears to be fine now, but you're right. That O-line, they got to protect him. Second quarter action with 1:59 remaining. And past the 40 before he's out of bounds. Set to begin their next drive, the Rams offense at the line. They are just putting things together so well here, drive after drive. They really have captured the momentum, haven't they?
They've taken momentum and pretty much not just give them a jersey, but a seat on the bench as well. Whatever do you need, you've got it, because the way they're stringing things together and creating that distance between them and their opponent, it's really hard to narrow that gap. And the other part is, they're taking their spirit away from them, too.
Yeah, now they're just looking to add to that total. I guess no need to force it when you can do that instead. First down, 18-yard gain. Going for Metcalf on the deep ball. And this is caught. He's got it. Touchdown, L.A.
Touchdown.
D.K. Metcalf. His third touchdown now on the year. And the Rams just continue to pour it on. And the route is on here in this first half.
Makes the score Rams 44, 49ers nothing.
Out is the kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away. Fielded a couple yards into the end zone. And they'll get him down right around the 25, actually the 26 officially. So a net gain of 1 there.
26-yard line.
The San Francisco offense ready to start their next drive. And you're under a minute to go in the half, a first half that hasn't been particularly kind to you. How do you think they'll play this?
Well, I think the smart approach is to run out the clock, lick your wounds at the half, and see if you can come up with a strategy to play better in the second. But it's also something to challenge in your offense right here. You know, hey, guys, you help dig this hole. See if you can get us out of it a little bit before the half runs out. Let's go make some plays.
They'll look to throw now on first down. In trouble, and he's taken down. The Rams going to go ahead and use the first of their timeouts as they'll stop the clock with 24 seconds to go in this first half. Sacks, a growing theme in this first half. This is second and long. Brought down after a very nice game. 22 yards there, first down. So we've reached halftime here in what is quickly turning into quite a rout. As we send you cross-country to Orlando, Jonathan Coachman is there and has our EA Sports halftime report.
Daniel Carlson set to kick off.
The Rams going to get the football first here, and they look to build on their lead as the second half gets started. That'll be taken about a yard deep. And ultimately cannot get this out to the 25-yard line as he's dropped at the 23.
Take over first and 10 at their own 23-yard line.
Set to begin their next drive, the Rams offense at the line. The last time out, another touchdown. And I think there may be some empty seats around here by the time the fourth quarter comes around.
Yeah, I have to agree with you because this was just about decided. But you know who benefits from all those empty seats? You and me, trying to get to the airport.
That's
the road to be fairly clear
that
by the time
positive.
We have to leave the booth.
Brings up second and 3.
To throw again on second down. Jones steps away to his left. And he's just going to get rid of this thing to no one here. He throws it away, and now it's 3rd.
Oh, that's got to frustrate him a little bit because they nearly got to him there, and it would have been the first sack of the game instead. They're able to influence the release, and they did force the incomplete pass.
So the incomplete pass on the last play, and that leads us to a 3rd and 3. Off the play fake, Jones. And this is caught by Watkins. Jones. And he is going to have a Rams first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. Just his second catch of the game so far. This one moves the chains. Here's a first down throw that's complete. And he's going to be out of bounds, but not before he takes it inside the 40. Two catches in the first half. Now he's got a third here, and it's good for a first.
One thing you're hoping for when you run drag routes, you're able to hit a receiver in stride, and he can pick up a lot of yardage after the catch. But in this situation, the defense was effective, able to stop him before he could get a good head of steam going.
Forced out to his left. And he just gets rid of it. Throws it away. The wise move there. Looked like nobody open. Now second down.
Yeah, that one sailed on him. You've got to make sure you give your receiver a chance to come down inbounds because they are very gifted. They'll make the circus catches, but they make them out of bounds. That does you no good.
Jones now to throw again. Going for Metcalf on the deep ball. And it's complete. He's got it in the end zone. Touchdown, Rams. DK Metcalf. His second touchdown of the afternoon as his guys continue to pour it on. And it's up and good.
Score, Rams 51, 49ers nothing.
The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. And this will be a touchback as that sails over the end line.
25-yard line.
The 49er offense set to get this drive underway. They have been struggling. I would imagine at halftime they went through some possible changes. Well, those changes aren't working, so now where do you go?
I think that now it's much more in their head. And what I mean by that is just what you said. You've gone over the changes. I bet they were pretty clinical at the half, not too emotional. They might need to go to the emotional side because you've got to find something, some spark somewhere. And so far, just being calm hasn't exactly worked.
They need any spark at this point. And he drops it incomplete. And their struggles continue here. So back-to-back incompletions, and that has him staring at a third and 10. Out of the gun, they look to throw. And the Rams got him. They bring him down.
It's been a tough one all game long for this offensive line. They're already down big, and now you know they're just going to come after the quarterback in a big way, don't you?
They just can't get out of their own way right now. It's created an avalanche, and an avalanche is coming right on top of them. And he's going to be out of bounds, but not before he takes it inside the 40. Oh, he nearly broke that one. As it stands, though, a heck of a 36-yard run back. And this offense, they're going to have excellent field position. They take over with a first and 10 on the short side of the field. Now Jones on first and 10. The open man is Westbrook. And he gets it down a yard or two shy of the 30 before he's out of bounds. They'll contain him to just four. Second down.
A gain of four. It's now second and six.
From the gun, Jones dancing to his left. And he's going to keep it here. And he'll go out of bounds inside the 15-yard line. I guess no need to force it when you can do that instead. First down, 18-yard gain. Now Jones, buying time to his left. He rifles one that's intercepted. Picked off by the former first-rounder, Jimmy Ward.
As much football as we watch, we've seen this work many times. In the red zone, first down, take a shot at the end zone, and points result. In this case, though, give credit to the defense. They outguessed them, were prepared, and intercepted the pass.
The San Francisco offense ready to start their next drive.
These guys had to punt last time. It has not been a very fruitful game offensively thus far. They haven't even made a trip to the red zone.
And I know that everyone's going crazy on that sideline because that drives you berserk to come off the field, not really move the ball well. As you said, not even get to the red zone, let alone, you know, not even put points on the board. They've got to just take a deep breath, relax, try and figure out what is working, and call more of that.
Second and 10 here as we roll along in quarter number three from Santa Clara. He's letting this one go for Fuller. He's got a man complete. 20, 10, touchdown, 49ers. Will Fuller, an 80-yard touchdown. And the 49ers able to get this back to some measure of respectability. The 21st pick back in the 2016 draft, Will Fuller, and we know that he can take the top off of a defense.
He certainly can, and the way that he does it is just straight, pure speed. And I talked with one of the better defensive coordinators in the league, and I said, how do you defend that? And he said, at times, you absolutely don't. If the quarterback gets time and he heaves it downfield, Will Fuller's going to outrun any coverage you put out there.
And he brings us out past the 20 to the 24.
On the return, the Rams take over first and 10 at their own 24-yard line.
Set to begin their next drive, the Rams offense at the line. And they had a nice little drive going last time through the interception in the red zone. Costly.
Bad enough to throw it anywhere, but that drives coaches insane.
It got his man complete. And he gets all the way down to the 30-yard line. A huge play that time for the Rams. 46 yards. Here's Jones. Off the play fake. Oh, a scrap for the football, and he's going to come down with it. And down inside the 15, shy of the 10. And they get 17 more on that one and another first down. Now a throw to the end zone on first down, but it winds up incomplete. The intended receiver was DK Metcalf, but it'll be second down.
Second and 10.
Jones. Jones hit and the ball's out. But it looked like a Rams player was able to get his hands on it. Yes, so they will hold on to the football indeed. Jones. Off play action. Being chased out left. And they're into the end zone, but it's not verified yet. Hold on, there is a flag down. So retract the yardage and retract the touchdown.
And retract the chunk play. Big strike there to get the touchdown. Now they've got to take it back and see if they've got another one still in their arsenal.
This offense converted once on fourth down earlier. Now they're out there again to try once more.
Hey, we got Mike, number 53. Mike, 53. Let's go, defense. Our time.
Mike, 18.
Operating from the gun, Jones. And the defense has it covered. It's intercepted. Picked off near the 26, the 30, the 20, 10, and into the end zone. A pick six for the 49ers. Deals, they score the touchdown.
Maybe a small measure of revenge for this defense because they've been thoroughly dominated so far, but a brief bright spot there with that pick.
Oh, they flip it to the kicker. He looks like he's going to throw it.
And he's got it in the end zone. Bit of a surprising call here, down by as many as they are, but the fake works, and they'll get 2 points closer instead of one. So they'll get another shot on offense following that pick six, and now the kick is away. Fielded a couple yards into the end zone. And they're going to have lousy starting field position as he's out of bounds at his 6-yard line.
Anytime you field a kickoff inside your own end zone, you've got to be decisive about whether you're bringing it out or not. Sometimes that indecision can really cost you. That may have been what happened on that play.
Set to begin their next drive, the Rams offense at the line. And following the pick six, and they had decent field position in throwing that pick six. We'll see how they attack this drive.
And I think all you say to your guy is, listen, let's just take care of the football a little bit better. Make some better decisions on this drive, and they'll probably help him a little bit with maybe some really high percentage throws early to let him get settled back in.
But they told us, they've got confidence. That's not a problem.
Yeah, not a problem at all. They just want to make sure they get things settled down a little bit for their offense and give their defense a little bit of a chance to rest.
And this shot downfield on second down is brought in. Touchdown, L.A. David Njoku, his first touchdown on the year. And this offense is running away with this one. When they drew that up, I don't think they envisioned it ending in a house call, but he got it and took it all the way home.
Really impressive run after the catch, wasn't it? That was really special by him. But let's face it, in today's NFL, those tight ends are often former wide receivers or maybe even sometimes bigger running backs. They just put them in a position to get a great matchup and make plays like that.
Over first and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
The 49er offense set to get this drive underway. They are right now just ice cold. I mean, they have struggled big time in this game, and they're getting blown out. How do they adjust?
So tough, because we always talk about it being a team game and you need all 11 working well together, but every now and then, partner, you need that one guy who could make a play against all odds that maybe can ignite things, and I think that's what they're looking for right now.
Yeah, you talk about going to your playmakers, they probably need to do it.
Find someone that you're...
Oh, this is taken in, it's complete! And they'll get this well past midfield before being stopped just before the 35. Line of scrimmage, the 37 on first and 10. Back now here in Santa Clara. And this is a blowout so far as we get set for the fourth quarter. A very one-sided affair.
Someone put me out cause I'm on fire. I can't give up about what they